Yesterday, we took an overview of all kinds of multi-phase systems, gas, liquid, 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 gas, solid, solid, gas, liquid, solid, and many combinations. And the principal objective is to determine the rate controlling step and estimate overall the rate of reaction. I announced that we are going to understand this step for one multi-phase system, gas liquid, and for other multi-phase systems, the same analysis will be extended, and that will be shown in the class how to perform the analysis for liquid-liquid, gas-solid, liquid-solid, and many other systems. So after taking up gas liquid, we considered four cases yesterday if the reaction is very slow. Typically it takes hours. Suppose there is some unknown reaction, and for example, let us take chlorination of toluene. Just for discussion purpose, chlorination of toluene. You have been asked to manufacture 50 tons per day of benzyl chloride, 50 tons per day, and design the reactor. So the first step is to understand what is the rate controlling step in this chlorination and whether we can write the rate. And then using the rate equation for overall rate of reaction, how to design the equipment, though we are not going to consider that step two in this lecture series, maybe some glimpses of that I'll tell you today. This particular plant I had designed in 1984. At the same time, I also designed another plant, acetaldehyde oxidation to acetic acid and acetaldehyde oxidation to acetic anhydride. Maybe let us take that. Same year, both the plants were designed. See, interesting, very interesting. Acetaldehyde, you put one oxygen inside and you get acetic acid. Acetaldehyde This is acetic anhydride. Both the chemicals are familiar with us, and these are extensively employed in industry. I said this is very interesting, right? The acetaldehyde, 2 moles need only one atom of oxygen for making acetic anhydride. And current price of acetic anhydride is 80 rupees a kilogram, right? Needs half the quantity of oxygen, and one atom of oxygen gives acetic acid, the price is 30 rupees. Less amount of chemicals, less absorption, and you make high value. I made a statement at the beginning of yesterday's lecture. Whenever I give any public lecture, I promise that I'll increase the profitability of your organization at least by 30% if I have not seen your plant. How do I do that? This is the method. So, if acetaldehyde oxidation is carried out, it is obvious that both get formed, right? But if you see the mechanism, acetaldehyde, oxygen, and further in the presence of oxygen, it oxidizes to acetic acid. So, in the plant, if we give sufficient time for oxidation, we will get 100% acetic acid. And if it is controlled, the oxygen is controlled, so this is as good as acetaldehyde. Product A goes to B and finally goes to C. And you are aware of in reaction engineering course, A going to B going to C, there will be certain rate constant here, there will be certain rate constant here. So, in the batch reactor, if you keep on oxidizing, say, for 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, you will get acetic acid. The intermediate product, it cannot be detected. Particularly, these large capacity plants are continuous. Next 4 or 5 sentences are very important. Today, fortunately, is a morning time. So, let us be attentive. You have been attentive yesterday also. So, in a continuous plant, we wish to make 50 tons per day. And there have been some plants. All oxidations are highly exothermic, The heat of reaction is more than 100 kilocalories per gram mole. And it is very important to maintain temperature, the oxidation temperature. Otherwise, the runaway reaction takes place. So, for maintaining temperature, we need sufficient heat transfer area, obviously heat transfer coefficient and delta T, so that the heat can be removed. So, whatever volume of the reactor and the rate of heat removal, so the most important point which I observed in 1984 was the reaction is heat transfer controlled was known. Maintaining the temperature is very important. So, volume of the reactor was decided on the basis of the rate of heat removal. How much heat transfer area can be packed, how much delta T can be kept, and how much heat transfer coefficient we can increase. And whatever volume of the reactor was coming up, that was more than 3 hours. And that was sufficient for making acetic acid. This is very important. So, A going to B going to C, I'm going to tell you how to understand the kinetics of this multiphase reaction. But if we understand the mechanism is, first of all, acetic anhydride is formed, which oxidizes further to acetic acid. And if we wish to have selectivity, if you want 80 rupees per kg, then selectivity with respect to anhydride should be increased. And there is a possibility, there was a possibility, and it was actually executed in the commercial plant with 70% selectivity. So, all acetic acid, perhaps only 10% selectivity of acetic anhydride was increased to 70% selectivity, and 30% increase in profitability is nothing when 10% is increased to 70%. So, the crux was to pack the heat transfer area, and therefore, whatever I have implemented, most of it is the knowledge of the manufacturer, right? But the knowledge I gain, I consider that it is for the cause of students. And I have learned a methodology how to preserve the rights of the manufacturer but still convey the knowledge to the student community. I know that, right? So you will understand the entire mechanism, all the stepwise procedures, how it was executed. So a heat exchanger was taken. Imagine one heat exchanger. I will not draw tubes. Maybe I'll draw one tube or two tubes I will draw. So imagine there are plenty tubes. Anyway, it is heat exchanger. It is supposed to do only heat transfer job. So in a typical reactor, stirred tank reactor, the practice was to fit about 10 square meter square per meter cube of volume, 12 meter square, and by innovating something, we could accommodate 20, 25 meter square. That was not sufficient. It needed more than 50, 60 meter square per meter cube. And in some of the hydrogenations, which if the time permits, I'll tell you, 100 meter square per meter cube, that much heat transfer area is required. And in the recent years, the micro reactors are becoming popular, and we even get 500 meter square per meter cube, 1000 meter square per meter cube as heat transfer area. Coming back to the example which is commercially implemented, here the shell side is the reactor and the tube side is used for the heat transfer. The reactor needs to be plug flow, and whenever in a pool of liquid gas is introduced, the gas generates sufficient turbulence, and the dispersion which I mentioned to you yesterday, that is very strong and keeps the entire column back mixed. It also generates internal flows, convective flows, that also enhances mixing, and in such a type of reactor we get back mixed flow. And if the acetaldehyde we want complete reaction, say 99 or 99.5%, the rate of oxidation is proportional to acetaldehyde concentration, which is 0.5% of the inlet. The rates are at the lowest level, and again the reactor volume is high and we get acetic acid. So again, in addition to the heat transfer area or the rate of heat transfer, the plug flow mechanism was. So we are using bubble column type of apparatus, and it is known to be completely back mixed, and it is to be made plug flow. So the same is now converted. You imagine a sieve plate is introduced. There is a downcomer, there is a downcomer. The sieve plate has holes, and the diameter and number is adjusted in such a way, say gas is flowing upwards, we select the number and diameter of holes in such a way that the resistance across the sieve plate is sufficient to have a gas space. So this is gas. Below this plate is also gas. And then bubbling occurs. The length of the downcomer is adjusted in such a way that liquid flows down. So with this sufficient resistance of holes, the liquid cannot come down through holes. And liquid coming down through holes is called weeping. All of you know what is meaning of weeping, correct? No? If I tell you to practice it just now, that is easy enough because it is known, right? So we try to adjust no weeping condition. So liquid should not come through the holes, it should come only through the downcomer. So that is adjusted with the help of resistance offered by the sieve plate. Because of that, the pressure drop across the holes is more than the h rho g of the liquid. So the liquid needs to come only through the downcomer, that if it has to go through these holes, then it is more than h rho g. So gas gets accumulated, liquid flows only through downcomer, only through downcomer, and if you adjust such about 10 sieve plates, you get completely back mix flow on one stage, second stage in all the 10 stages, and you have 10 stirred tanks in series, which is more than plug flow. Understood? So sufficient heat transfer area was provided, and plug flow was organized, and the residence time needed was 10 minutes for getting 70% selectivity with respect to anhydride. With that 10%, 10 minutes residence time, indeed. See, good part of any reaction is, if it is carried out for 10 minutes with residence time, we get 70% selectivity in the laboratory, in Mumbai, in Dehradun, in New York, in Paris. The same thing is going to happen. That is a good part. It never deceives. What is difficult in chemical engineering, that I will tell you later. So the rate controlling step identification and estimating overall rate of reaction, how this was done for this particular case, that I am going to teach you. The need I have amply described. We want selectivity with respect to acetic anhydride. We want to be not acetic acid manufacturer, we want to be acetic anhydride manufacturer. So this is the need. The need is, we should be able to transfer the heat at sufficient rate. The need is to organize plug flow. This much is known, and I schematically showed you. I did not explain you in very great detail, but how to organize plug flow and how to pack the heat transfer area by carrying out reaction on the shell side. So you pass gas on the shell side and there is a liquid, whereas the cooling water is on the tube side. Reaction temperature is about 60 to 70 degrees centigrade. So when air is passed for oxidation, at the inlet, 21% is oxygen, right? 21% is oxygen. As the gas bubbles move, the oxygen percentage goes down. The partial pressure decreases, right? And at the outlet, depending upon percentage excess provided, if we provide say 100% excess, then oxygen at the outlet will be 10.5% because it is 100% excess. If we provide 20% excess, then accordingly that much oxygen will be at the outlet. In that case, the percentage excess, see, on one side, the partial pressure of oxygen increases with percentage excess, and with oxygen partial pressure increase, we get increased saturation concentration S star. And let it be in any regime, if S star is good, you get good rate of reaction, or the volume of the reactor goes down as partial pressure is increased. So it is a good idea to increase the percentage excess. But when we wish to do that, the air is supplied by compressor. And you know how to calculate compressor horsepower. Typically, we can say the pressure here, that much pressure needs to be generated by the compressor, and the pressure drop is h rho g multiplied by volumetric flow rate. So if you wish to provide that much power for a given, so what do? I said yesterday, I am going to tell you today, and I will catch at least three more occasions to tell you the same thing again and again. What do? We know nothing. That is easy. We know nothing. But now we are capable of, up to certain extent, up till now, and after half an hour you will be definitely capable of calculating for a percentage excess the reactor volume. So you take 300% excess, find the reactor volume. The reactor volume will be small. Take 200% excess, take 100% excess, take 50%, 20%, 10%, 5%, and find the volume of the reactor. You find the volume of the power needed for the compressor for all these percentage excesses. And the power consumption, if it is say 50 kilowatt, you know how to calculate 50 kilowatt hours multiplied by 8000 hours of operation multiplied by 8 rupees these days or 10 rupees, you know what is the yearly bill. If the reactor costs say 1 crore of rupees, you have yet to study, I think, chemical engineering economics. Or you have done already? Yeah, right. So you don't know the terms depreciation or the interest. So whenever we install any plant, commercial plant, typically we don't use our own money. Some percentage we use, of course, 15-20%, and the remaining is taken as loan. And there is a life for the equipment, and if we have spent 1 crore of rupees at the beginning of the installation of the plant, every year it depreciates. And if the life is considered as 10 years, then the cost of the equipment is 10%. So 10 lakh rupees, it goes as depreciation. You need not worry about this explanation, but the capital cost has some contribution, this much you can remember. Plus whatever money is taken as loan, that interest is also to be paid. So as the equipment size goes down, the depreciation and interest, the capitalized cost goes down. But on the other hand, the compressor power, it keeps on increasing with percentage excess, and we always calculate. Year after year I have been teaching, and we try to develop this particular ability, and this is with all ICT students. In the mind, you have an embedded chip. Whenever anybody gives any idea, in the mind calculation should start. How much it is going to cost us initially for the operation? Is it beneficial to us? What are the risks? Is there any safety problem? Is there any pollution problem? Right? We should calculate. If the idea is good, appreciate that fellow immensely. If the idea is not good in the mind, just smile. So all ICT graduates, they know how to smile. Understood? So this particular aspect of while designing, keeping these points in mind, I have repeated once. I have told you two times. I'm going to tell you 3 more times, all right? When I take full class, I do that 50 times. So you assume that I've been telling this 50 times and remember that. These rates we calculated. Now here if you see the partial pressure and therefore a star is decreasing from this point to this point. Whereas countercurrently acetaldehyde is entering and the product is going out. So B naught, where acetaldehyde is pure, it has certain concentration at the top. Whereas the oxygen concentration partial pressure is minimum. Whereas at the outlet is unreacted acetaldehyde, which may be 0.5%. So 200 times less as compared to top. The oxygen partial pressure, if it is 20% excess, then it is decreasing at least by a factor of 5 from inlet to outlet. The point is, from point to point, A star and B naught are changing. From point to point, A star and B naught. Is this clear to you? Similarly, we wish to maintain, say, 70 degrees, that is the operating temperature, and there is a rate of heat removal as well. But the temperature of 70 degrees is not uniform throughout. Somewhere it is 75, somewhere 65, 67, 63, 62, somewhere 73, 75. So there is a temperature profile also, in addition to concentration profile of A star, concentration profile of B naught, there is a temperature profile. On top of that, when you bubble anything and take 1 meter cube here, take 1 meter cube here, take 1 meter cube here, the number of bubbles in this 1 meter cube, this 1 meter cube, this 1 meter cube, they are different. The bubbles are different. Or in other words, the value of epsilon L, it also changes from point to point. So how to consider all these points while executing the step one, that is determination of rate controlling step and overall rate of reaction? We need to vary A star and B naught depending upon, we should be able to visualize the variation in these concentrations in the commercial reactor, and that much variation should happen in the laboratory of temperature, of A star, of B naught, of epsilon L. All that should happen, and we should be able to write very systematically the overall rate of reaction. So that is the need. And how to do that? I told you, with the help of model contactor. And we call that contactor as a model, has two characteristic features. It has definitely known interfacial area, and there is a facility to vary mass transfer coefficient, right? So we do that in all the cases with the help of course, model contactor, but I'm going to explain to you with the help of stirred cell. Is it visible? Let me try with the help of a slide. Normally, I draw it myself. Yesterday, I showed you, this is the gas-liquid interface, this is the impeller in the liquid phase, and there is a gas phase impeller, which we rotate at very high speed, 2000, 3000 RPM, in order to eliminate the gas side resistance or make the thickness of the film on the gas side negligibly small. We can rotate this impeller so that the interface is visibly flat, and typically speed up to 120 revolutions per minute, that gets permitted because of the requirement of the flat interface. So you can change from 10 RPM to 120 RPM, right? Now try to understand. If we take dependence on epsilon L, let us see how it is written in this slide. I'll use the same nomenclature. So in terms of no and yes. So if it is, if that reaction of acetaldehyde oxidation is very slow, then it will be proportional to epsilon L. There is no epsilon L dependence. There is no epsilon L dependence. There is no epsilon L dependence. I derived this yesterday. Typically, the second term is much higher than 1 in 99% cases. So, if you neglect 1, A star cancels and you get KLA B naught by Z dB by dA. That is epsilon L. If you take KL, true KL, so is there KL in regime 1? So, no. Is KL there in slow reaction? Yes. So KL. Is there KL in regime 3? No. Is there KL in regime 4? Yes. Interfacial area. Is interfacial area here? Array, speak loudly, participate. Oh. Very good. Is there A here? 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 Interesting, no? Then let us take A star. In the regime 1, it is A star raised to M. Here A star raised to 1. Here A star raised to very good. And here? No. B naught. B naught raised to N. Here? No. Then? And here? That more or less completes the analysis. You can make some observation. There is no A star dependency at all in regime 4. There is no B naught dependency in regime 2. The KL dependence, if you see KL dependence, it is KL dependent in regime 2 and regime 4, but as far as B naught is concerned, see, KL dependence is not there in 1 and 3, it is there in 2 and 4, but B naught dependence is not there in regime 2, but it is there. Similarly, A star dependence is not there and A star dependence is there. So, there is a sufficient background. Should I repeat whatever I said? Yes? I'll repeat. Even if there is one yes, I'll repeat. We want to understand whether the reaction is very slow, and if we identify and conclude that it is indeed very slow, then we need values of M, N and K, M, N so that we can really find or establish the rate of reaction. So that procedure I am going to tell you. But first of all, we need to identify the regime in which the gas liquid system is operating. And for that purpose, we are using this matrix in which regime it is prevailing, right? So for that, how many things are there? If you take liquid hold up, only it affects the rate of reaction in regime 1 and not in all the other regimes. We don't know value of M and N, but still the considering KL dependence, that is, we know that in every model contactor there is a possibility of changing KL in stirred cell with the help of impeller speed. I'm going to show you at least 5 more model contactors and tell you what is that definite interfacial area and what is the facility of changing mass transfer coefficient. So we can change mass transfer coefficient, and if it depends directly proportional to KL, either we are in second regime or in fourth regime. All right. If B naught dependence is there, we are in fourth regime and not in second regime. Right. So in this manner, if you see interfacial area, it is hold up dependent, but interfacial area dependence is not there. But in all second, third and fourth, interfacial area dependence is there. The another point we can use, we have already written very slow, fast and instantaneous. So there is certain time frame required. So if you want, say, 50% conversion, very slow reaction obviously is very slow and takes hours. And instantaneous reaction is indeed instantaneous, and it happens in seconds, several seconds. So without knowing, so this, our starting point is we know nothing. So we don't know acetaldehyde, we don't know oxygen. But if acetaldehyde formula, we know. If you are given acetaldehyde and oxygen, you can take stirred cell and start doing experiments. In a stirred cell, there is an inlet for the gas, there is an outlet for the gas. So you pass air, there is sufficient airflow, you take acetaldehyde here and start rotating impeller speed. Now from we know nothing, we have started, correct? We have taken whatever is given in acetaldehyde, and so we change the impeller speed. We change the impeller speed and carry out the reaction. Whether it takes hours or whether it takes seconds, several seconds, it will be easy to understand, no? Right? So whether it will be in second regime or fourth regime, typically we will come to know without referring to this matrix. Right. So it is KL dependent, so we are either in second and fourth. Then later on we can check, we vary the concentration of B naught, that is acetaldehyde concentration. Acetaldehyde can be diluted with acetic acid. In order to reduce the concentration anyway, the product is acetic acid, and vary the concentration of acetaldehyde. So if it is directly proportional to B naught, and anyway it is happening in several seconds, then we are in fourth regime. If it takes time, it takes several minutes, then we are in regime 2, correct? So if you see on top of that, if you see the effect of A star, that is, if you pass air, then the partial pressure is 21% times whatever is the pressure of operation, that is atmospheric, and we know that partial pressure. We can do the same experiment using pure oxygen and increase A star almost 5 times, or dilute air, or in the air you add oxygen and vary partial pressure, and you can take 6, 7, 8 levels of partial pressure, vary A star. If it depends upon A star, we are in regime 2. If it is independent, so if B naught dependent, A star independent, and happens in several seconds, it is instantaneous, and we know how to write overall rate of reaction. If it happens in several minutes, if it is A star dependent but B naught independent, we are in regime 2, right? This clear now? अरे इट वॉज क्लियर बिफोर, आई एक्सप्लेन वंस मोर एंड नाउ इट इज नॉट क्लियर. इज इट क्लियर? द ओवरऑल ऑब्जेक्टिव दो दिस इज क्वालिटेटिवली अंडरस्टूड, वी मस्ट डू इट क्वांटिटेटिवली. एंड आई टोल्ड यू यस्टरडे द कंडीशंस अंडर विच एनी वन रेजिम प्रिवेल्स. इफ रूट एम इज ग्रेटर दैन थ्री एंड सफिशियंट बी नॉट इज अवेलेबल इन द फिल्म, देन ओनली वी आर इन फास्ट रिएक्शन रेजिम. राइट? सो वी शुड बी एबल टू एस्टैब्लिश सच अ कंडीशन quantitatively, not qualitatively. Qualitatively we can make observations, conclude preliminarily, but later on, before the final conclusion, we must establish the values of each and every term, try to analyze the values and establish the regime in which the reaction is operating. So, for calculating the values, so if you want to calculate value of root m, in root m, if you refer to your notes, root m has m, n, it has k, m, n. Right? So, we need values of those rate constants and orders of reaction with respect to A and B, then only we can establish. However, the KMN, M and N, they are there only in first regime and third regime. KMN is not here, KMN is not here, M is not there, N is not there, M is not there, N is not there. And we want values. So whatever reaction we are carrying out, we need to push it either to regime 1 or regime 3 if we wish to get M, N and K, M, N. How to do that? We were comparing these two rates. If this rate is much lower than this rate, then this is reaction controlled. That's what I explained yesterday. If this rate is 10 times lower than this rate, then it is reaction controlled. So it is mass transfer controlled and reaction controlled. So with the help of impeller speed, if we increase the KLA, the value of KL in particular, in the strut cell using impeller, then the rate increases. With respect to speed, and eventually when this term becomes 10 times larger as compared to this, eventually it levels off. We have deliberately enhanced the rate of slow reaction and made that part 10 times larger than the regime 1 rate and made it deliberately reaction controlled operation. Understood? So when we get reaction controlled, then we can change. We know that the overall reaction is regime 1, but the values of KMN, M and N are not known. So we change B naught, takes say 5 levels, 6 levels, 1 kilomole per meter cube, 2 kilomoles, 3 kilomoles, 5 kilomoles, 10 kilomoles per meter cube, and plot ln rate versus ln B naught, the slope is n. Similarly, A star also you can vary. I told you the methodology, pure oxygen is 100% oxygen, air is 21%, you mix oxygen with air, you can get 40%, 60%. You mix nitrogen with air, you can get 10%, 5%. Take 10 levels of partial pressure, there will be 10 levels of A star. Plot log of rate versus log of A star, you get value of M. When A star is known, B naught is known, M is known, N is known, epsilon L is of course already known, which I will explain to you, which gives the value of the rate constant. Do same experiment over a wide range of temperature, at least 4 or 5 temperatures, you will get activation energy and can find out rate constant at different temperatures. Subject is over. Once more, let us do that, the same thing for the fast. I have told you how to recognize quickly whether we wish to bring the overall reaction in regime 1. Why regime 1? Kmin is there, m is there, n is there, which we want. And then later on it is in regime 3, otherwise it is not there. So if it takes hours, then we are going to take efforts to bring the overall reaction in regime 1. What is required? That this term has to be 10 times less than this. So you can do it by increasing impeller speed and changing KL. You can reduce B naught also. If it is required, reduce B naught and reduce this overall rate so that we come in regime 1. Similarly, as you see, if we wish to push it here, so either it is instantaneous on this side or it is on the slow side, and we want to push it here. So what is that can be done? Now let us discuss for some time. So reaction can be anywhere. It takes several seconds, it takes several hours, several minutes, few minutes, several minutes, several hours. So either we can say that quickly we can identify whether we are here or whether we are here. Now if you want to push here, what is that we can do? So suppose we are on this side and we want to go here, what is that we can do? Increase the temperature. Very good. So that is one. So we are making this reaction faster as compared to this, right? What is that we want? The root m, which I told you yesterday, we want to make it greater than 3. Do you remember? 2 upon m plus 1 dA Kmn S star raised to m minus 1 V naught raised to n. Upon KL, square root of this. This we wish to make it greater than 3, correct? So one idea which was very good, keep on enhancing Kmn so that the numerator increases. What is the other possibility? Yeah.
We can go, by increasing temperature, we can go to the first regime also and
third regime. Right. That is a possibility. Right. That is a possibility. Is there any answer? This is an excellent question. By enhancing Kmn, we can go either in regime 1 or regime 3. Which one is preferred? Yeah. What is the answer? So if we are enhancing Kmn and enhancing the rate, it will not go towards very slow. That is correct, no? We are going to go to fast. But I thought your question was, if we are somewhere here, whether we should go here or whether we should go here. Perhaps that was the question, which is very relevant, So we should see the practicability. We know that for first regime 1, it needs several hours, whereas the regime 3, it needs few minutes. If intrinsic reaction, if it is taking minutes, then it is a good idea to go to, because pushing it to regime 1, if you are making slow, it may not be possible. In 5-10 minutes, it is going to happen completely, and you will not get any reading. Understood? So very slow, it will take some time. So that this particular first two, three experiments, they really tell us whether to push it to 1 or push it to 3. Minutes, regime 3. Hours, regime 1. Okay? That is that simple. Now, you gave me one idea, enhance Kmn by temperature so that we can try to get root m greater than 3. What is any other idea? Interfacial area is not there in root m. Root m we want greater than 3. Read this. Very good. There were two ideas, both were correct. Reduce KL so that root m can increase. And somebody said increase B naught, the concentration B naught, so that the numerator can be increased. So we want value greater than 3 so that, and we don't want here, as you see, there is no KL dependence, right? There is no KL dependence. Of course, interfacial area is there. So in this particular regime, we must see to it that it is impeller speed independent. That is most important. Anything, let it be regime 1 or regime 3, it is impeller speed independent, and therefore the kinetic parameters, they prevail only in regime 1, either in regime 1 or regime 3. So if you are here and vary B naught, again 6, 7, 8 levels, and plot log rate versus log B naught, slope will be n by 2, right. Similarly, take A star oxygen partial pressures from 5% to 100% oxygen and plot log rate versus log A star, the slope will be m plus 1 by 2, from which m can be obtained, n can be obtained. At every partial pressure and B naught concentration, we know the overall rate. And here is the importance of known interfacial area, which permits us to estimate value of Kmn. Do the same experiment at various temperatures, you will get Kmn. And the activation energy at those temperatures, which will permit us to get the. All right? So that really completes step 1, and now it is to be extended to liquid-liquid. But prior to that, let me take this subject forward. Explanation of the same points in different languages. There is a possibility to write behind. Okay. But this we wrote yesterday. That is, if this is much less than, and this is much less than, the conditions under which these are satisfied. If that is not the case, and if it is in between, then we know the. So, the possibility of estimating m and n and Kmn that we established, and we can always find then the value of this term and the value of this term for any operating regime. So suppose you calculate, I showed you bubble column, at every point you can calculate the value of this term. Now everything is known, m is known, n is known, Kmn is known, their holdup is not known. From location to location, holdup is not known. The value of KLA from location to location is not known. And this is the most difficult part in chemical engineering, which I tried to cover in step 3, and I wrote step 3 yesterday, estimation of design parameters, mass transfer coefficient, gas side, liquid side, heat transfer coefficients, interfacial area, they hold up values. All these are design parameters which are very useful for the design. But since we are not going to cover step 3, you assume that I have covered step 3, and with the help of that we are capable of finding interfacial area as well as mass transfer coefficient, right? The methods of estimation are covered there. Or I can give you one reference. With the help of that, you can read the reference and try to, which I will circulate to you. Not only that, I will give you reference, I will circulate the reference for estimating a KLA, the heat transfer coefficient, the hold up in say bubble column reactors. I'll have to give one reference each for every type of reactor, right? And there are not many, there are 300 reactors which are in commercial operation, 300 types. So if you go to the literature either through Web of Science or through Google, you will be able to get. But anyway, the subject is much bigger than whatever I am saying today. You assume that there is a procedure for estimating A and KL or KG or heat transfer coefficient, but this is not easy. This I must tell you in advance. Sufficient expertise is required, or sufficient expert advice is required for getting these values, but not impossible. So having known M and N and epsilon L and A value and KL, you can estimate everything including root M. So you know whether you are here, whether you are here, whether you are in between, here, here, or you are here, in between, here, here, or you are in between. Yeah. Right. So the instantaneous, we wish to make it fast, right? What is the another way? One is you have nicely told. Kamenka. Yeah, B is correct. In regime 3, we need B naught constant throughout the film. So B naught has to be sufficient, right? So if you take lot of B naught, keep on increasing B naught, you go towards regime 3, right? So increase B naught, that is one. Then what else we can do? Decrease the? Take 50 seconds to give me final answer. 50 seconds. This row, decrease or increase? Decrease. At least there is a uniformity. This row? Still you have 30 seconds. Okay, so 50 seconds are over. What is the logic? Why to reduce impeller speed? Yeah. Good, very good. I'm very happy. Very happy. You are understanding that fast, and you have made my job very simple, very simple. Now, what was the title of the lecture? Determination of rate controlling step and estimation of overall rate of reaction. That is the title of the lecture series, right? And we are doing it, we are executing it for gas liquid system. We have yet to see large number of other multiphase systems, but lot of similarities there. But how we have executed? We have taken one model contactor. We have established the matrix, used the matrix for typically finding out whether we are in the slow part or we are in the fast part. After doing that, We either push the overall reaction in regime 1 or regime 3, try to get Kmn, M, N, the activation energy. After doing that, with the known values of KL, A, and the holdup, we establish the values of all the four and value of root M, and then find out where we are. After finding the values, it is likely, most likely, that we are never cleanly in any one regime. We may be in between here, we may be in between here, that possibility is also there. But we know how to write the rate, which we wrote yesterday. Here in between, we said yesterday, A star, that equation is there with you, upon RAA is equal to 1 upon KLA plus 1 upon epsilon L. V naught rest N. If you are in between here and here, then you know RAA is equal to A M plus 1, B naught raised to N, plus, very nice, plus KL square. This I did not teach yesterday, which I will teach you today. The there is a term which I am introducing you today, and it is enhancement factor, right? Enhancement factor. When it is mass transfer controlled completely, then that is called base case. We compare the enhancement with respect to KLA into A star, right? So the enhancement factor in regime 3, for example, if you divide this rate with KLA into A star, what is that you will get? You get root M. Is that clear for everybody? Divide the rate equation of regime 2. You divide the regime 3 by regime 2, you get root M. And here, if you divide by KLA into A star, the enhancement factor, which is written as phi A, which is equal to, we are dividing by KLA into A star, so 1 plus B naught by Z star. dB by dA. And if you are in between 3 and 4, then the enhancement factor phi is equal to root M phi A minus phi upon phi A minus 1 raised to half. So ultimate enhancement factor phi A is known to you. This value is known to you. We can calculate value of root M, and we calculate the value of phi, the enhancement. So after getting enhancement factor, the enhancement is over and above KLA into A star. So the rate in between third and fourth is KLA into A star into enhancement factor. In between 2 and 3, what is the answer between 2 and 3? What do we do between 2 and 3? Is it written on the board?
Yes, yes.
Is it written on the board, this row? Where it is? Right side. Okay. Is that right? So between 1 and 2 is here, between 2 and 3 is here, between 3 and 4 is here. So what do we do? After knowing the values of Kmn, Mn, N and activation energy, now in the bubble column I told you the partial pressure is changing from bottom to top. B0 is changing from top to bottom. The temperature is changing from point to point. Epsilon is changing from point to point. After knowing the values, at every point in the reactor, you estimate all the four values and then try to establish which condition is satisfied, and with the help of that, write the overall rate of reaction. So that completes how to understand the mechanism, how to establish the rate controlling step out of the four, and having known the rate controlling step, how to write overall rate of reaction. Can I announce that we have covered this step one for gas liquid system? Yeah. Any questions are, all the questions are welcome. Yeah. Right.
Epsilon and A will have an interdependence of their own.
Yeah.
And in this case, they are both independent.
Yeah.
So how do we account for that in case of when we move away from the stirred cell?
So stirred cell is to be used only in the laboratory. If you are moving from the laboratory, you are anyway moving. Right. And when you are going to the plant, stirred cell is not there and the bubble column is there. So you, when you are in the plant, talk about bubble column. When you come to lab, talk about stirred cell.
Whatever equation they have derived are for only for the stirred cell, right? These equations that you have derived, they will work only for the stirred cell system.
See, in the laboratory, we establish order with respect to A to B M. Right? What will be the, in the laboratory, order with respect to A is M. What will be the order with respect to A in the plant? Which one?
Epsilon and A.
See, so about M, N and Kmn, there is no problem? Right. So the design parameters, epsilon, L, KL and A, this I have not taught you. This will come under chapter 3, that is estimation of design parameters. And let it be any one of those 300 equipment, how to get KL, A, KG, heat transfer coefficient, how to establish that is already covered, let us assume, or I have given you sufficient references. But the methodology, though it is same, the values of A, KL, KG, these are different in variety of equipment and different levels of power consumption, different levels of gas and liquid velocities. This will be different. But there is a procedure, right? So for stirred cell, there is a procedure. We call it as a model contactor because we don't need procedure. A is known, therefore it is called model contactor. Okay. Is it that clear? I'm really, I cannot be that happy. Hey, make me little unhappy, huh? So that was more or less conscience. the opinion was the same for going from regime 4, that is towards 4. We are not exactly in regime 4. We are going towards 4 for pushing it back to 3. Why to reduce impeller speed? All right. So this is the enhancement factor for sufficiency of B naught. For sufficiency of B naught, what do we want? The root M the value of root m has to be less than phi a, because phi a contains lot of b naught, and therefore now root m we want to, as far as between fourth and third is concerned, we want root m to be less than phi a, right? But for pushing from second to third, we want root m greater than 3, where root, the root m kl is there in the denominator, kl is in the denominator, and when impeller speed is reduced, the denominator is reduced, root m increases beyond 3. All right, now for pushing it from here to here, we need to ensure that there is sufficient b naught available. So the what do we use there? We keep on increasing b naught so that this condition is satisfied, root m is less than phi a. So whatever is there in root m, which is not written here, what else? I think somebody told reduction in temperature also, so that Kmn can be reduced, but we should not reduce in such a way that it is less than 3. So we must keep that condition in mind, it has to be greater than 3, the enhancement factor, but less than phi a, so that it does not become instantaneous. But in reality, as I told you, as oxygen partial pressure is changing, as B naught is changing, as temperature is changing, it is likely that at the bottom it is in some regime, at the bottom near the wall it is in some regime, as you go up regime may keep on changing, and we must understand from point to point how to write overall rate of reaction. So for every liter, if we write overall rate of reaction and add up, integrate all the rates throughout the equipment, we get the total performance of the equipment. That is our step 2, that is called process design. How to estimate at all the points and how to get the overall performance, or for the desired overall performance of 50 tons per day, how to select the diameter, height, the number of tubes, the sieve plates, the number of holes, the diameter of the hole, in such a way that we design the reactor. But that we cover in step 2, that we are not covering. But what we have covered, given partial pressure, given B naught, given temperature, given epsilon L, we know from point to point how to determine the rate controlling step and how to write overall rate of reaction. Is that right? Should I teach all over again? Is that all right? I think I should teach for 10 more minutes. The procedure is very clear. You do the experiments, 4 or 5 experiments, we know nothing. Right? We know nothing. We do some experiments. For 50% conversion, we note down for that partial pressure, for that. Is it taking hours? Is it taking few minutes? So either we are somewhere here or somewhere here. If it is taking hours, try to push it to regime 1. If it is taking several minutes, push it to regime 3. And you now know how to push it to regime 1 with the help of impeller speed, value of B naught, value of A star. You can maintain the conditions in 1 and 3. By varying A star and B naught over a wide range, it gives the values of M and N, and therefore Kmn. Vary the temperature, get the value of activation energy. So the values of rates in 1, 2, 3, 4 can be estimated at any point where partial pressure is known, B naught is known, temperature is known, hold up is known. We find the conditions which get satisfied, which does not get satisfied, and we write the overall rate. If it is purely in first regime, between 1 and 2, between 2 and 3, between 3 and 4, in 4, we can write overall rate at that point. So at all the points within the equipment, we now know how to write the overall rate of reaction. Okay? Is that okay? You have understood, I am able to read your faces, your voice is low. I think you need a cup of tea. And something to eat. So I will say same thing again when we reassemble, then let us see whether you have understood. Okay? So let us take a break.